I'm Brandon at Coeur d'Alene Tractor, Adams Tractor of Spokane and Lewiston, and Boundary Tractor of Bonners Ferry. Today I want to show you how to put a snowblower on one of our LX cab tractors here. Currently I have it set up right now in front of us for easy setup. We've got the drive line. I've got the subframe and the snowblower. So basically what I'm gonna be doing is I'm gonna be pulling this tractor up right on top of this. I'm gonna pick this subframe up, put it on top of the tractor, then I'm gonna cinch it up, connect the hydraulics and the mid PTO line, and then I'm gonna drive up and connect the snowblower. That's the process that you're gonna see here in just one moment. Okay, so now that I've moved the tractor on top of the subframe here, I'm just gonna be lifting up the subframe and putting these hooks right onto the frame right there. It does take a little extra strength. It's not super easy, but if we can slide this over in place, can just pop this on. And now we're basically ready to go for the next step. Now I'm gonna take this pin, I'm gonna put a little pressure on the subframe here so that way it's in place. And then I'm gonna slide this pin all the way through and it fits perfectly snug, just like that. Now I'm gonna come around to the other side and slip this pin through the other end. So the next step that I just made it through was I fed all of the hydraulic lines through this coil here. Now I'm going to connect each hydraulic line to the hydraulics on the tractor. So they're all color coded, yellow for yellow on up. And basically it's important that you understand that the bottom one and the top one are going to be controlling the cylinders of the upward and downward force, while the middle two are going to be controlling the chute rotator on the snowblower. So the next step is I'm going to be pulling the tractor into the snowblower. I'm going to connect the pins and pull back the lever to connect the PTO to the snowblower itself. Then I'm gonna raise the snowblower to get some pressure on the frame where I can then pin the rear and then connect the drive shaft. Then the snowblower is ready to go. Have this pin that I'm going to be putting back into the very rear of the subframe, and it can only go in from one side. Then I'm going to lock it in place with this pin on the other side. The next step is for me to take the mid PTO drive line and connect the long end to the rear of the snowblower PTO shaft first. Once I do that, which it's important that you do it exactly level, I then take the other end, which has a little quick coupler, to slide right onto the mid PTO shaft for the tractor. I'm gonna have to wiggle that on sometimes and twist it around until it clicks into gear. Snaps right in, it's on. This snowblower is ready for us to use. Any more information you want to learn about the snowblowers of Kubota, you can look at cdatractor.com.